Sony doesn't rest for long, and to prove this, they presented a new professional format in 1992 called Betacam, which is based on Betamax. Betacam uses a component signal, that means the luminance signal has been separated and there are another two signals for color, R-Y and B-Y. This separation of the video signals achieves the broadcast quality. The Betacam cassettes use the same tape as the Betamax, so can be used both on Betamax and Betacam units, but the signal on the tapes are different. Even so, to use the Betamax tape in Betacam machine is not recommended, as the mechanics in the cassettes are not very good for the higher tape speed, so it will be extremely noisy. So the cassettes are very similar, but the format is different. Betamax uses a composite signal, so all information, color, luminance and others, are merged into one, that means fewer details for each of them. It records using two heads, while Betacam uses four, for the component signal with 5 times higher tape speed. This means the Betamax L750 tape is enough for only 30 minutes in Betacam. Later, many Betacam units were upgraded to Betacam SP. In 1986, a new member of the family arrived, the Betacam SP. SP means superior performance. This format became the leader of the studio technology for many, many years. The picture quality had been improved and new features introduced alongside more practical usage. Another important thing was that large cassettes were introduced, which enabled 90 minutes recording time in NTSC and 108 minutes in PAL. The Betacam SP uses metallic tapes, so it's not recommended to use these in Betamax machines as they cause heavy wear on the heads. The cameras can use only the small size cassettes. The studio units can use both size in the same mechanics without adapters. All Betacam units are very heavy, but they were built in a clever way using panels, so any part can be replaced quickly and easily. The top range is the broadcast series, BVW, 2 linear audio, 2 AFM hi-fi, so it has 4 audio tracks, 2 timecode tracks, 1 longitudinal, LTC, and 1 vertically recorded next to the picture, VITC. It was also possible to add a PCM digital audio adapter. The Betacam SP was the most common studio format of all time. In 1991, a cheaper professional line came to the market, the PVW series. It was simplified, some of the functions were left out from the machines. In 1993, the ultra-low-cost series, the UVW, was launched, even cheaper and fewer features, but lower quality material usage as well. This series uses only 2 audio channels, but with an optional adapter it was possible to upgrade it to 4. The digital Betacam came to the market in 1993. This was the second digital format using tapes after the D1, but at an affordable price. It uses 2-to-1 compression digital component signal, 10-bit YUV, 422 sampling rate, and is able to record the full resolution of PAL or NTSC signals on 90 megabit per second on speed. It has 4 audio channels, 48 kHz, 20-bit PCM, and the Q channel. The LTC and VITC timecodes were kept. Also introduced the SDI, Serial Digital Interface, all digital information, audio, video, timecode in one package can be sent on one coaxial cable. The small size cassettes give up to 40 minutes, the full size cassettes 124 minutes maximum recording time. Some models are able to playback Betacam SP cassettes, but it's not possible to record on it. The Betacam SX from 1996 was a budget digital format between the Betacam SP and Digital Betacam. It used MPEG-2, 422 sampling and 10:1 compression, 4 audio channels, 48 kHz, 16-bit PCM. Most of SX models can record on SP tapes, but digitally only. The first HD studio format introduced in 1997 was called HD Cam. This was 8-bit compressed 3:1:1 sampling but 1080i. As the picture format was still 4x3, the recorded size was 1440x1080, and for 16x9 this was extended to 1920x1080. This method is called anamorphic recording. The same was used on DVD and its usual G-Beta masters. The HD Cam is able to use 24 and 23.976 frame per second, 144 megabit per second data speed, 4 audio channels, 48 kHz 20-bit. On the cinematic line, the Cine Alta used this format. The MPEG IMX from 2001 is a digital Betacam improvement, so still SD. It uses H.262 MPEG 2 Part 2 codec with higher bitrate, 40 to 50 megabit per second, and intra-frame compression, similar to Apple ProRes. The MPEG IMX offers to record on the small cassettes 60 and 220 minutes on the full-size ones. The HDCam SR Superior Resolution from 2003 was the last digital tape format. 10-bit 422 or 444 sampling, up to 440 megabit per second on data speed, and the full 1920x1080 resolution recorded with 12 audio channels, 48 kHz, 24-bit. Some models were able to use a doubling mode that was for 3D. In the HQ mode, the data speed were raised to 880 megabit per second. A third recording mode, which was added later, the SR Lite, used higher compression, the data speed limited to 220 megabit per second. The small tapes 40 and the full size ones offers maximum 155 minutes recording time in 24 frames per second. The biggest and most important advantage for Sony against its competitors was that they were able to think on full systems. What I mean? They offered all steps for studios on any budget on a very high quality, from portable machines, camcorders, audio and video mixers, FX machines, editing controllers, so all studio functions were covered and all units were able to work together as a part of the system. Sony used the color coding for the cassettes: dark gray for Betacam SP, light gray for UVW series SP, blue for Digital Betacam, yellow for SX, greeny blue for MPEG IMX, black for HDCam, and dark gray with cyan tape lid for HDCam SR. Other brands of Betacam machines, mainly for SP, existed, not just Sony. The BTS, Thomson, Ampex, for example. But the only difference was the badge. Inside, they were exactly the same as Sony. Some interesting features was always in the machines, and these are continuously improved. Like the two audio channels became four, and from Digital Betacam, all four could be edited separately. Finally, the number of audio channels have been raised to 12. They had an internal edit controller that was able to do edits between a player and the recorder. There was a comfy head for reading immediately after recording, so able to watch the recorded picture. There was also a pre-read function for reading immediately before deleting, so the recorder could work like a separate player in the same time. These are, of course, some samples only. In this figure can be seen the evolution of Beta systems. Green, the Betamax, and red, the Betacam family. In 2011, the Fukushima catastrophe and tsunami caused shipping problems for Sony, so the studios started to use more often the digital file delivery instead of tapes. Over the years, the professional technology completely moved to the file-based systems. Thanks for watching and see you next time.